I shall kneel as you bow your heads and I will pray. Dear Lord, we thank you this morning for being with us throughout the week. We thank you for the blessing of the Sabbath. We thank you, Lord, that as about we read, that you've bestowed upon us minds, Father, that are capable of thinking. Help us to use our brains, Lord, as you have designed them to work. And help us, Father, to not be distracted. And help us to listen. And as we hear these things, may we esteem to do them, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, we ask all of this. Amen. Amen. I greet the church once again. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
My presentation today, I told Sister Naomi about it during the week. It will be about some research that was done by Scott Ritzmer. Most of you might know him. He does a lot of seminars on education, on the media and the brain, and all of those things. This research that he did, it just captivated my mind so much, and I just thought, Lord, I have to share this. And I hope that the Lord may help us as we try to make these changes in our lives. Ne? The book, CE, Councils on Education, ne? It says, there is nothing more calculated to strengthen the intellect than the study of the scriptures. No other book is so potent to elevate the thoughts, to give vigor to the faculties as the broad enabling truths of the Bible. If God's word were studied as it should be, men would have a breadth of mind, a nobility of character, and a stability of purpose that is rarely seen in these times. That is what the Bible. Do you see how powerful reading the Bible is, ne? And the Adventist message, the Adventist people, they were known for to be people of the book.
Mm.
Yes. Am I believe? Oh, okay. I didn't see her. I'm sorry. Okay. I'm going to try to. This is going to take more time. Is that fine? I'm going to try to translate here and there. Ne?
Yes.
I forgot. So, kule ncwadi le education, ne, kune quotation ku Councils on Education. La khona u Ellen White akhuluma khona about ingqondo. Ukuthi ayikho into ekwazi ukuthi iphakamise indlela yethu yokucabanga njengelizwi likaNkulunkulu kulifunda. Kuthiwa ke ukube izwi likaNkulunkulu liyafunda kulesikhathi esiphila kusona, besizoba abantu abanemilo ezikahle, sibe nephepho, sibe nenhloso yokuphila, sibe nendlela yokuphila le engabonakali kule khathi esiphila kuzona manje. Ngesikhathi sasendulo, ama-Adventist, ama-Seventh-day Adventist, bekwaziwa kuabantu bencwadi, besaziwa as people of the book. But today, since everything has changed and we were introduced to the media, to technology and all of that, and we are no longer known as people who exactly. So there was also what you call the printing press, ne? The printing press it changed the course of history, ne? The printing press brought about literacy to everyone in the world, ne? It changed how humanity actually interacted with one another. It changed humanity broadly, ne? Dramatically, basically. It brought forth movements and reforms in rapid forms, ne? It brought the reforms by Martin Luther. We wouldn't have Martin Luther's tracts and the German Bible and Tyndale going out to the common people.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. So a printing press my figure emhlabeni yilaphona kwaqala khona ukuthi kuhanjiswe yes kuhanjiswe izwi ngendlela ebhalwe phansi ibingekho kwandulwa ngithi siyazi ukuthi even in a sentiment yase Eden it was just Adam no Eve kuphela ngithi uNkulunkulu bekakhuluma naye ngezwi kuphela bebengafundi lutho phansi it was supposed ukuthi ingqondo zabo kube yizo ezisebenzayo so ilethe ushintsho olukhulu indaba yem yokuthi kubhalwe phansi kwani community ukushicilela kweincwadi ne so ya letha khona ama reforms ne abo Martin Luther nabo Tyndale labo bantu laba esibazi as ama reformers labo bantu laba ke bakwazi ukuthi imibhalo yabo ifike to the common people ne. All right, we are blessed to be called people of the book, ne? People who received God's word in written form, the truth of God that is. So there's a legitimate fear, ne? That the very civilization that came to be in the last 500 years since the printing press was invented is in danger. So le printing press le lokuthi kube khona phansi imibhalo encwadini kusengozini kanjani. Okay, if we are in a digital information age, is it possible that we've confused information with knowledge and wisdom and that a digital dark age is upon us? Could it be possible where real literacy is under fire? Could it be true? So kulesikhathi esiphila kuso kungenzeka yini ukuthi i-technology ithathe indawo yayo lencwadi le ebhalwe phansi isikhala sako lokhu ofanele sikufunde phansi ne. So Dr. Martin Wolf who is a cognitive neuroscientist, perhaps one of the most formal experts on reading and the reading mind in the world ne. The title of her book Reader Come Home, it suggests that we have to recapture the art and act and skill of reading. So kukhona udokotela ne oyi neuroscientist owacabanga ukuthi kufanele kube nendlela yokuthi sibuyise back iart yokufunda phansi izinto ne skill sokufunda.
Yes,
umkhulu yamjabulisa le nkulumo ne he's very happy about this ne Elder Zulu and I understand why. Okay, she writes the benefit of reading books, ne? If you're a book reader and you have literacy at the forefront of your life and you're a reader, you will be more. So she lists 5 things, ne? So number 1, she says you will be more critically thinking. So kule ncwadi leya lo mama lo le neuroscientist ubhala izinto ezi-5 eziyama benefits wokufunda ne eyokuqala yayo uthi uzoba umuntu ofunda critical ocabanga critical critical thinking
ohlolisisa
kahle indlela yakhe yokucabanga ihlukile ne. So you will be a critical thinker and when you think about that ne, she's not Adventist or anything but when you think about it doesn't God say come let us reason together?
Yes.
Doesn't God want us to be human beings that reason?
Yes.
So uNkulunkulu ufisa nathi lo aspect le ukuthi sicabange siyisebenzisa ngithi ngoba uthi wazani sikhuluma indaba ngithi uthi in the book of education it says let us not be mere reflectors of other men's thoughts but let us be thinkers. That's the book of education. Education ithi asingabi abantu abathatha lokhu kwabanye abantu si reflecte kusenze bona ne kodwa sibe abantu abazicabangelayo singathathi even when isikhathi se COVID isifika even when the times of COVID hit us ne we could see that people were just reflect they would just take and take but God wants us to think ne. All right. And number 2, the 5 things that she's listed is creativity. When you're a book reader, ne, your creativity levels they increase. So you will be a critical thinker and you will have creativity. The book of education again, ne, page 17.2. It says every human being created in the image of God is endowed with power akin to that of the creator. Individuality, power to think and to do. So creativity, we were created like God in the image of God. We were made to have the ability to be creative. Ukuthi sibe abantu abanjani aba creative abafana noNkulunkulu. So that was number two. Number three, you will have personal reflection. Now don't we get that even from the Bible itself? 2 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 5. Can we all open our Bibles there? 2 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 5. So the third aspect, she says, it's personal reflection. Doesn't Paul say, okay, we'll read the verse. Personal reflection. So that's what I'm saying. These principles that she has laid forth, they are very biblical, if you think about it.
Can I read it?
Please read. 2 Corinthians 13 verse 5. Can someone also read it in Swati?
Read it in Swati,
yes.
It says there, 2 Corinthians 13 verse 5, examine yourselves whether ye be in the faith. Prove your own selves. Know ye not your own selves, how that Jesus Christ is in you, except ye be a reprobate. So we are told that to examine ourselves.
Personal reflection. This is one of this is the third thing that she stated, ne? So she speaks about personal reflection. Can you come there? Yes. Examine yourself. So when you read, this is one of the things you need to gain from reading something, is to examine it, to personally reflect upon something. Then she says, when you read a book, when you read of the lives of individuals, like reading real stories and history, like the Protestant Reformation and the Advent movement, all of those things, if you read them, and other great people who have accomplished great things, you start to look at that as a mirror into your own heart and life. You look at Martin Luther and you esteem and you think that, wow, Lord, he did this, and you want to change, you want to remove some of the things in your life. You esteem to be more like them, if it's personal, if it's things that are positive. All right. And then number four is empathy. Empathy. Can someone translate that? What is empath? Kuzwelana. Alright. Thinking. Okay, empathy, it's thinking and feeling somebody else's feelings. Thinking about them, walking in their shoes. They say that this increases when we are book readers. So, empathy, iyakhula kithi uma senza njani when we read a book. When the Bible says love your neighbor as yourself, it's saying care about them, be willing to sacrifice self to uplift the benefit of another. Stanford University found that when you're reading stories about people, there is actually mirror neuron activity happening in your brain. You're identifying with their experience when you're reading carefully and deliberately, not just speed reading, which actually means you're getting not much mirror neuron activity. So there's something that happens in your brain uma ufunda, kukhona lokho kwenzakalayo on a physical level la engqondweni yakho uma ufunda incwadi, ne? Kuthiwa ke indlela yokufunda akusiyo ukuthi nje ujahu ukuqeda, indlela yokuthi you are actively ufunda kahle, ufuna ukuqondisisa kahle lokho okubhalile. Counsels to parents and teachers and students says we should not read superficial types of books, ne? Reading for entertainment value. And don't we do that, especially on social media? Have you guys noticed that okay, my sister-in-law would say this a lot about herself even, ne? Which is true for most of us, I would say. When you find a post on Facebook or whatever social media that doesn't have a picture and it's a really long text, it's boring, ne? You just quickly scroll up and you just find something more interesting that is short and, So there's, like I'm trying to explain here that... Ellen White in the book of counsels to parents and teachers and students, she said we should not do artificial reading. Can you imagine that in her days, Ellen White, there was no media and technology at that time. So they were book readers. Those people were book readers, but they would just choose to read other things besides ones that are elevating. They would read fictitious stories and all of, and she warned much against that. Can you imagine if she was living in our day and age, what she would be warning us now of? ne beka esikhuza ngalezo zinto ukuthi singabofunda izincwadi ezingasikhulisi thina ezinga yeah. Another statement says that if the appetite of our reading was not spoiled by those types of books, ne, the superficial types, the young people would pronounce the Bible the most interesting book they have ever read. Kuthwake ukuba besingafundi lezo zinto. So in our day and age, it's very serious because technology is something else. Uthi kulesikhathi sethu ne ukuba asifunda ezinye izinto, asifundi le ma superficial thingies. Besizosho ukuthi iBhayibheli liyincwadi a very interesting esike sayifunda nje emhlabeni. All right. So in our brains ne, there is no circuit for reading. Amanye amazwi ayikho indawo laphakathi in our brains that is dedicated specifically for reading, ne? There isn't a dedicated circuit of the brain classified as the reading area. We piece together a lot of different areas in the brain when we learn to read and we develop a reading circuit. So in other words, you will develop, the more you read, you will develop a place in your brain that is specifically for reading. It's just connections that are made in your brain and they will be formed to form a reading circuit in your brain. Okay, it says when you're reading, you're piecing together circuits from two hemispheres of the brain, four lobes per hemisphere and five layers of the brain. It fires off in a millisecond when you identify the meaning of those characters and put them together. So when you're interacting with whatever you're reading, something magical happens in your brain that I cannot even explain. Okay, did you know that you have more connections in 1 cubic centimeter of your brain than all the stars in the galaxy? Can you imagine that? When it says in the Bible, love the Lord thy God with all thine heart and thine mind and strength, it literally means that. So it means when in part of our service to God, when it says love the Lord thy God, with all of thy, we cannot say with all of thy heart only, but it says also with our minds. We need to love the Lord even with our minds. Being thinkers, being readers, being intelligent is God's ideal for us. The media intends to dumb us down. Neil Postman in 1985 in his book Amusing Ourselves to Death, he showed from recent research from that time that the more television you watch, the less intelligent you become. So television was dumbing us down with the type of media at that time. And if we can think about when TV was invented, I think it was in the late 80s towards the 90s. And then listen to this research. Ish, and I keep forgetting to translate now. Okay. Kukhona umuntu bakuthiwa uNeil Postman ne, ngo 1985. So I'm wrong. Yeah, 1985. Kuthiwa ke wabhala incwadi. Kuleyo ncwadi yakhe wabonisa ke ukuthi ukubukela iTV kukwenza ukuthi ube yisidomo. Kwakungalesa sikhathi ne 1985. But what about with the advent of the internet and other types of media, which is now, ne? What about now? They say by 2003, King's College University of London found that in studies, kids were already performing two entire grade levels below where they were in the 1970s. So one generation later, two grade levels dropped by 2003. So in 2003, they found that abantwana ababukela iTV ingqondo zabo bese ziyehlile nga 2 grades. Ngamanye amazwi umntwana ingqondo yakhe mayifanele ibe ku grade 6, it was ku grade 4. You understand? It was 2 grades lower just by watching TV. This is not technology and social media or anything. They were already going down just by television. So now that we have smartphones and social media, what now? So they say since the advent of the smartphone and social media, SATC scores, particularly in language and reading, have dropped 13 points each in just 10 years. Now, how did that happen so quickly? So SATC score is basically your APS score. You know that score that you need to go to university when they say you need so many points, so many points. They say that score when social media and technology was introduced, it says that it dropped by 13%. So I don't know if I should continue. This is a lot. I still have quite a long way to go. I really wanted to go to the end, which is more encouraging us to actually be people of the book, to go back. Because as you can even see me, I'm reading this from my phone. And everything that we literally do, we do it from technology. Yonkinto siyenzayo, siyenza technology based. It's quicker, it's faster. I wanted to write this down in my book because I usually write, ne? But it was more quicker. You know, even using our phone sometimes, I noticed with me, I don't know with others, ne? There's predictive texting, right? So the when you're typing, it will literally just pronounce the word for you. It will write out the word for you without you completing it, ne? And then you'll just press it and you accept it. It makes us not know how to write. When you're literally writing yourself, ne, you forget, how do I write this precaution? And then you keep, it just, you know, this research, ne, touched my heart because I can see that it is true for our lives. I wanted to also go in the technology that they introduced in schools, but because of time, I will do it in the next family wellness that I'm granted to stand here, ne? To show you guys that even when this new technology that they put in schools, because the government is funding that technology be introduced in schools, ne? They want children to be now working everything from the computers and everything and everything. Then I'm gonna read to you the research done on that. That it actually it's dropping us, ne? So with all of this being said, in the end, these will be taken away. The Ellen White estate is here. Your books are here, basically. Ne? It's easier. If you want something to search, you search it here. It's way easier. But this will be taken away from us very soon. And can you imagine not having this? I mean, they will shut it down. They are able. If they can shut the network down, ne, they will be able to shut your phone completely down. And if you're dependent so much on it, have you noticed that even when you're addicted to social media, when you wake up, the distractions even on it, when you're trying to read your devotion, your messages are coming in and then you see, oh, did she just say that? And then your mind is no longer on what you were reading. You now have to look at that WhatsApp or whatever text that's now emergency or something. Ne? So may God help us to go back and be people of the book. You know, I like it how Brother Thurston now, when he presents, he doesn't give us the verses anymore. He says, open your Bibles. Because that challenges us. And the phones, ne? You know, with the phones, what I noticed, ne? The people who will open the text on the phone will read first. You know why? Because it's easier to find it from your phone where that book of the Bible is. But if you open here, ne? And then they say Nehemiah, you have to think, come here, where's Nehemiah now? I forgot. Then you will have, that will build something in your brain. Let us go back, brothers and sisters. Let us be people of the book. Carry your Bibles. You know, we used to encourage each other, Sister Carol, remember, that we need to get literal Bibles now and stop reading from our phones, ne? So by God's grace, even the young ones, I will get to that, how what they say about reading when they're reading to them, even when they can't read or write. So may God help us that we return, brothers and sisters. Amen. I will ask Brother Nkosi to please close for us in the way of God.
Thank you that you have spoken to us today, giving our sister a message to share with us. And we are all, we know, we can testify to that, that the words that were spoken here are true. We ask of you to please give us strength so that we may say no unto these things and go back to be the author of the book. Please be with us as we carry on with our lessons. We pray that you continue to bless us with your presence. I pray and I ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Lord, I care not for riches, neither silver nor gold. I would make sure of heaven, I would enter the fold. In the book of thy kingdom, with its pages so fair, tell me, Jesus, my Savior.